got you in that red zone and then on my cue. Coach O, draw up the play and we gon' slide through. Slime you, get you stepped over like Ty Lue. It don't matter if you 6'9 or you 5'2. Throwing on pads, put on the cleats, foot in the dirt, slip on the gloves, yelling out straps, ain't nothing sweet. You can get hurt out on the field, ride for the team, grass in the streets, even on turf, snapping on three, throwing them dots, see the technique, putting in work. Hail Mary, feeling something like I'm Pac. If it ain't us, then you nothing but a I. Tri-County, man, we coming for your slot. High bounty, put a hundred on your top. We seen crime, seen drugs, seen murder, seen guns, seen death, seen jail, seen further. This game done saved some lives. We certain, we grind, we hustle, we move it, we working.
Boy,
yo, what up,
what's up? What's going on, everybody?
Yo, we working, episode 11, dog.
Damn,
yeah. 11, that's crazy.
It's going fast.
Yeah, real fast, bro. Real fast.
We got a special guest in the building, man.
Yeah. Give it up.
My boy from Georgie Pine, Yellow it's Stages the Pine, in the building. The
what's going on, everybody?
Yeah, we got a little red in the building, okay?
See what color I got on?
Yeah. It's the setup for Saturday.
I had to walk around Ooze's house to make sure it wasn't a setup.
We put the Woodbury jerseys right behind
you. Yo, it's the most least Paul's bro Woodbury trash talking I've seen in a long time.
Damn, it's crickets out here. Bro.
Is it a coincidence you brought me on the show today? Because,
I saw you here. I'm gonna need some backup. All right,
just as long as you're with the bird.
Shit, Martin was reffing the JV games at Deptford today. He gonna try to walk out. I said, bro, I ain't got time for that bullshit.
We young this year, man. We real young, so.
He said, you need to switch the subject.
Switch the subject. That's funny as hell. Yo, listen, man. Week one. It's a wraps.
Week one is in the books.
In the books. We was waiting on your game and shit, you know what I mean?
Right. Glad I got my shit on Monday. I feel good.
Week one in the books.
In the books, man.
You came in the building dry, head and shit. That
thing's shiny for a different reason.
He ain't got no hand towel. He bought the towel. He bought the beach towel with it.
Just in case you get crazy.
And your shit ain't glistening.
You got a white t-shirt on too.
Yeah, right.
We in this bitch.
Yo, man. Listen, man. Guys, we have week one reviews.
Yeah.
And we got, we did our power rankings, our dynamic 10.
Yeah.
Little heated discussion earlier.
Yeah. Yeah, we was going at it.
I was like, no, ain't no way college do that shit. I play football all my life.
PT was trying to tell me some bullshit, man.
And you know all I'm going to say is, man, they stink.
That's cute word for everything. Man, they stink. I'll say the only put them on the list.
Yeah. That and the doo-doo emoji. All
right, put them on the list. Put the poop emoji next to them.
I really said that. Yeah.
He said there were two of them. Yeah. I'm like, man, come on, bro.
Oh, shit. That's fucking hilarious,
it's
bro.
It's funny because dudes be running down on me now, too. Like, you said we was going to lose by 30.
Yo, people come up to us all the time. You do rankings. The heat is on you now.
Yeah, it is. I agree with that.
It's love, though. It's much love. I love that shit. Though. That means shit, you know what I mean, getting out there.
And they paying attention.
Yep. Yeah, man. I appreciate all the love, man. Going through the games this past weekend, a lot of people showing a lot of support to the podcast, saying how much they enjoy it, how funny we are on here, that how these stomachs was hurting, laughing, crying, watching the podcast. Yep. So, you know what I mean?
So funny last week. Oh, man.
Yo, okay, what up?
Without K, congrats on that big win, baby.
Yeah, man. Give it up for K, man. Let me get my boy K and Ryan. It's been a long time, man.
That's enough. That is enough. He only beat Paul's, man.
Hey, B-Max. B-Max, go for the shirt, dog, and the hat.
Q, I'm right. It ain't going to be a whole bunch of that.
Hey, guys. The main reason why I asked this guy to come on the show today. Let me get a push up for a week.
Do I gotta get out the way?
Damn.
Hold on.
Owe me 17 rides for one.
What Kevin Hart say? Help!
I don't need to push up right now. I was about to say,
you gonna do that too?
Nah, I don't need to push up right now, cuz.
You know I gotta talk my shit, kid.
Yo, Lex.
PT.
Brooms. Oh,
they brought the brooms out in Paul's. Hey,
why is Paul's brother subject?
I know, like, it's week two. What's on week two, y'all?
Calvin really kept good. Starting this shit. Calvin and all of them kept starting. He said, hey, leave us off the corny podcast.
That corny ass podcast.
We dish it, out, we gotta take it. But after we take it, we're gonna give it right back.
Oh my god.
Get him off the
show. It's too early.
Did you hear this freak in the corner?
Christ. What is he talking about?
Oh, shit.
He ain't even coaching this year. He went right into it.
Jesus Christ.
Setup is real.
Serious about that one.
Hold up. Oh, they go to sweat.
Hey, damn.
It's the lights.
Nigga, my hat making his head sweat.
Oh shit. It's the lights.
Oh man.
Honestly, man, y'all start y'all shit already, bro.
That's George started it, bro.
Oh my god.
Isaac, you missed the executive board meeting at 9 o'clock.
Mm. Who said that?
Mm. Sewell.
Fire, boss.
Man, listen, Sewell, the freshman president, too. One of us was there. Like, both of us was there.
There you go.
Sewell got a lot of time on his hands.
What's up, Sue? I didn't see Sue when he speaking. He was showing mad love. Definitely showing love.
Yeah, me and Sue the same category. Yeah. Fire volunteers.
Yeah. Go to all the beats now.
All the games.
All the practices. But ain't coaching.
And eating all the cheeseburgers.
Oh, shit.
Y'all funny as hell. So, man, let's talk about this
week one, man. Week one, man. Let's talk about week one. First matchup, which y'all want to go to?
Well, Q just got done, so we can go. He fresh.
Monroe, Woodbury, week one.
Yeah, we can go there.
Freshman.
Throttle.
Oh, man, freshman. What was the final scores?
We don't want to talk about that score. Yeah. But
listen. I did the clock for the freshmen.
Uh-huh.
The freshmen, they just need experience.
Yeah.
They're not bad. They're not a bad team.
Nah.
They just need experience. And the coaching staff need the experience.
Yeah. And they played against all good teams.
Yeah. So yep.
Sterling, Clayton.
Yep.
And then they went into that monster, Monroe.
Oh, man.
Soon as I got there, I heard a little cousin ran down the sideline and scored.
Sophomore.
Elijah Holmes. Scored the first touchdown. I was like, good Lord, I just got here.
We can ask PT for scores.
PT, like, encyclopedia.
My man Rip's son had a nice one.
Bro, I was up there like Rippy Jr. for a touchdown.
Every time Monroe scored, he said it all over.
That's how you do that shit.
Touchdown, Monroe.
That's exactly what I was doing, bro.
Right.
I couldn't even get sued for my guys. Ain't nobody score.
Exactly. So I said, you guys are embarrassing me in front of my friends. We need some touchdowns on the board.
Oh, man. So we talk about your game.
Sophomore game.
Sophomore.
How'd you feel about that decision to hold your game off until Monday?
I didn't like it. I tried to fight it. But then, like, the way the refs was acting a little bit, you know what I mean, calling everything. One ref told me it'd take 2 feet to get it in for a catch.
He said what?
2 feet for a catch. My man, 4 from about 12, we catch the ball, 1 foot in. They said, hey, got to get 2 feet.
this the NFL?
Yeah, yeah. I didn't get.
I didn't get it either.
Hugh stinks. I was. He didn't put up 30. He stinks. Like he said.
Oh my God! Was that game live? Did y'all go live?
Nah, I wasn't there.
Bro, it was like a minute left. I was throwing bombs.
Yo, the kid didn't catch it though. He almost had 30.
Catches five people on his back, dragging them.
Yep.
Tackle, fumbled on the one.
Yep.
Damn. He was going for that 30.
I was going for that 30, man.
You trying to run the score up.
Y'all terrible, bro. Y'all worse than Mike. Y'all worse than our sophomore game, we hype. We trying to get on the field. It's 23 seconds left.
Mikey's still throwing the ball.
Call timeouts. That was
timeout. Soon as he down, timeout.
Throwing the ball.
You know what the main thing everybody say, though? I'm working on something.
I wasn't working on nothing. Mike said I couldn't score 30 on him.
I'm working on something.
They started stalling me out deep out in the second quarter. Then the ref says to me, the play clock, right? You get 25 seconds to 35 seconds.
What? It's 25, but it could be 30,
35. Bro, it's second quarter. They running 35, 40 seconds. So my coach just got the clock right next to the whole game.
Ain't the flag on
him. How long is the play clock?
He said 25, but he can go from 30 to
35. Nah, I think the play clock is more than 25 seconds or midges.
Yeah, he said he can go from 30 to 35. I don't know where that rule is.
Did everybody make it through on the cussing rule? Did everybody make it through safety?
Yeah, yeah.
I don't know how Calvin made it through. Goodness gracious. Because Calvin ain't going to make it through the season. He lucky that was Mikey's cousin over there. That wasn't the white dude.
He would've been gone. They wanted me out.
Calvin would've been out. He lucky that was Mikey's cousin, bro. If it was a white dude on that sideline, Calvin would've been out. Telling you,
I had the head rep in the treasure.
Bro, yep. This nigga Zay was about 5 yards off sides on the kickoff and recovered the him off sides.
They said he was across the line before he even. He made contact with the player before he even kicked the ball.
Hey, yo.
And they let it go.
And they let it go.
The ref was like this. Hey, y'all, can y'all back up a minute? When he turned is when we was kicking the ball. He ain't see it. I'm like, Zay. This nigga recovered the onside kick. He could have scored, but you ain't allowed to pass the ball, right?
Oh, shit.
Calvin lost his mind. Yeah. I couldn't, yo. He lost his mind,
as
bro.
As he should, bro. Man.
That shit was funny, bro.
Because the Mikey's cousin said that he seen him go offside, but that's his side that he can't call that.
Wow.
But yeah. I seen the penalty, but I can't throw the flag.
That's crazy,
bro. You know what Mikey's cousin did?
Mikey's cousin
called Zay's touchdown back just because he was offsides.
So he balanced it out.
He threw the flag for no reason.
Oh my God.
The shit's on film.
He just threw a flag out.
He threw the flag, said, hold on, number 42. I'm going to show you the play, bro. It was crazy. Yeah. He just threw the flag for no reason. Like, nah, he was offsides on that kickoff, so he called a touchdown.
That's what I'm saying. On my game, my coach got the play. He got the head, all the ball, foot down. Yeah. I take two feet. What are you talking about?
Nah, it's only 1 foot.
It's one but all the way through college.
They threw the flag on Calvin, though. They was like,
sideline. They was like, sideline warden.
One more, he's gone.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I said, they got that Harvey effect. We all act the same way on the sideline.
Oh, man.
Yeah.
Nah, but it was a good game. We won 20-66. Darian Peterson had one touchdown for about 5-10 yards. Carl had 3 touchdowns.
Brisson said Carl had all the time. Brisson was talking real heavy on you today.
These guys is crazy. If you combine both of these scores, it's probably 60-something to 0. And these guys keep threatening me. Stop tagging me.
Damn.
Until you score. Damn. If you ain't scoring, stop tagging me.
Damn.
They got Violet and Brisson kids on the team.
It's hard to make up 40 points.
It's hard. So and I was being nice. I was going to go back to my regular shit, being nice.
Nah, don't be nice.
I ain't being nice for football season. Yeah.
What about that junior game? How y'all feel about that junior game?
Oh man, I liked a lot, but then it's just a couple things I just can't. I don't understand. Mm. I think now, especially us traveling 7-on-7, that 12U.
Jabril said, fuck
yeah,
you.
I saw that.
I thought that wasn't going to talk about it today. Jabril keep bothering me.
Yeah, we'll see him. We'll see him Saturday. But, you know, being in the circuit of 7-on-7, you start seeing the quality of the passing game.
Mm-hmm.
But, you know, our juniors, man, they old school, so to speak.
Yeah.
So it's frustrating to watch, but we all trust Legend. You know what I mean? We all trust him.
Mm-hmm.
They'll find a way, but at sometimes, man, you gotta spread that field let up, it fly. Man. Let it fly.
Yeah. I can understand that, but I think people want him to do things with a team that doesn't allow him to do it.
That was my point, and I don't think he has the quarterback right now to do it.
I don't think he has the skill guys. I think he's getting the maximum out of his team what he got.
Right.
Because I don't think there's a lot of talent on his team. Like, he has some good players.
Right.
But I don't think he has a bunch of it. You know what I mean? Like a whole bunch of guys that can switch in and out, guys that can play different positions. Right.
Mm-hmm.
I was impressed.
Right. I mean, we were standing next
to know what Monroe has on their team and the amount of athletes they have on their team, Monroe is stacked with talent.
Yeah.
Monroe, on paper, Monroe and Woodbury, that game shouldn't even have been close.
But if they play again and meet in the playoffs, can Woodbury win that game?
Yeah.
I don't see Woodbury being able to win that game. Like I said on the podcast, before the game, exactly what happened, that Woodbury will be able to stop their run game.
Mm-hmm.
But when it comes to the passing game, Woodbury don't have the skill guys.
Right.
Mm-hmm. They don't have the DBs. If Monroe just step back and throw the ball every play, they'd probably blow them out. They could, you know what I'm saying? Like,
crazy.
Is that Julian Sonnen quarterback?
Yeah. He's back from his injury, so
he grew a little bit.
And his arm got a little stronger.
And he's
flicking that ball out there.
He got a live arm.
He threw some good balls.
You know who the player of the game was that game?
Who?
The kid Roy.
Yeah.
He was the player of the game. They switched him to corner. Coach Al snuck that in there. I was holding the chains. They made a move and put a kid at corner. He changed the whole game. He was on Jeff's third down play, and he came up. He didn't go for the pick. He went for the hit and ran through the kid. And the whole team got fired up.
In-game adjustment, moved in the corner? Or that's where he started
it? In-game adjustment.
In-game adjustment.
They got beat like third down like once or twice on it. Then they made that in-game adjustment. The kid made a play. Mm-hmm. Whole team got excited.
Yeah.
So shout out to them boys, you know, coaching. You know, week one is rough. You know what I mean? Because as coaches, we know the plan. We see the kids, and we just want to go out there. But you got to add the holdings in there. All that stuff you wasn't seeing in the scrimmages, you're going to see in the games. Because I know I used to watch my tape, and I used to be like, yo, my right tackle, he's 10 yards downfield on every pass. You know what I mean?
Don't say that shit on the podcast. Right? You rest grade me looking for it.
They already did. The whole first quarter was 0-0. They called two touchdowns back, I think it was. You know what I mean?
Shit. You didn't score 30.
They called a holding call.
Yo, this is a slime you joint. We are not promoting NLG here, brother. What is that?
That is Miss Janine. That is the South Jersey AYF cheer director. Hey, Miss Janine.
Hey, how you doing, Miss Janine?
She is a teacher at NLG.
We love NLG, but not right here.
We'll leave my girl alone.
This is a Slime U podcast.
Everybody, you see it right here. Yellow Pages from
shout out to the Yellow Pages
from one of my players, Macklin Weber. Oh. One of my gifts from him.
You owe me Sprint, son. That's in your practice.
Your ass is gone, dog.
What? It had to do with a Yellow Pages jersey. Yeah, I was going to kick up the field.
I got kids that come with slime on. That's all I love. That's all I love.
When we play in Paulsboro, we don't like that shit.
I don't care.
We ain't allowed to wear red either. It's red. but shout out to the Yellow Pages, man. Doing big things, man.
Right.
Let's go to second game, man. Let's go to Bristol and Whitman.
No, we ain't go to O's game.
Oh, sorry.
That was my bad. That was the highlight of the day.
Man, so, he put the points on the board.
It was supposed to be the highlight.
Hold on. Did O stink it up or did Monroe step up?
You know, I can answer that?
Yeah.
The film. Film don't lie at all. Mm-hmm. We left 42 points on that field.
Damn.
I got proof. I'll bring up my account right now.
You talking about a missed block or?
I'm talking about holdings that the ref said all he had to do was just keep his hand inside. Hands. But he went like this. Jay turned the corner. Called back. inside, our center, same thing. He went outside. Jay went right up the middle, touchdown, called it back.
Y'all had two touchdowns called back?
Yeah. Two touchdowns called back. Then we had two touchdowns drop, hand slants, wide open. Boom. Then we had TJ dropped one in the back of the end zone, hit him dead in his hands. He was triple covered.
Yeah, that was good defense. Yeah. That was good defense.
He dropped that in the end zone. And then Jay running outside.
Don't say TJ dropped the timeout. I want to cuss you out.
Are these all different possessions?
Yeah.
They're all different possessions.
All different possessions. And then one, Jay bounces to the outside, bro. We all got our hands up like you're ready to score. The corner comes out of nowhere and just gets him like in the legs. Film showed our receiver ran a route instead of run blocking. He would have just stood right there in front of him. Jay walks right there.
Damn, 42 points. That's a lot of points left on the field.
Bro, but you got to give him credit. That was good defense.
Yo, listen.
Three cold dime stops. They played good defense.
Listen, bro. This is for all the Monroe coaches and players. What happened to all that speed y'all try to threaten us with? Because y'all put a goose egg up. Donut.
And both of y'all put a goose egg up.
No, listen. Listen. I'm not taking nothing. We left shit on the field.
Yeah.
We won 7-0. We are not hype. We're not posting that shit by any means. I mean, the players got highlights that they did, you know, the camera shit. But
they said they had the speed. They said they had too much speed.
They said they had best speed in the league. And we counted that. And I'm gonna give kudos here. I'm gonna give a shout out to Q. And when we used to play Millville, you taught us coaches how to deal with that speed. And when they said they had all that speed, I just went back to the archives. No, I got this. They not doing shit. I think they had 5 first downs the whole game.
Yeah, you're right about that, Kato. That was the main thing I seen this week. A lot of people left money on the table.
Yeah,
you know what I mean, just week one stuff.
It was a rusty week one. A lot of penalties. PT saw the game. Yeah, you know what I mean. It was a lot of that in week one. It's all right. week one, I think.
What up, big
fish? All the football I watched this weekend. It was a very sloppy week one. Very sloppy week one from everybody.
I just want to say one thing. The turnout at our field this weekend was crazy.
Yeah,
bro.
That was crazy.
Yeah, it was electric.
That we had the most electric sight all weekend, bro.
I was there 3 different times out of the day. I came there for the 7U game. Left. I came back for the juniors. Left. They came back for the senior game.
Yo, it was bumping. And listen,
it was with the rain and the weather.
Right.
Yeah. It was a lot of support, man. Y'all had the grill jumping out at the back
of the corner. Yeah. Shout out to my parents.
You know what I mean? The concession stand rolling. Yeah.
Like I said,
I was mad. I just ate. I was like, damn, man. I just bought something to eat. I walked up like, yo, grab me a hot dog.
My parents was tailgating. They was out there tailgating.
In the back of the end zone?
They was in the back in the corner with a little gazebo at. They had their own party.
Shout out for Monroe, man, coming through like that, man. Shout out to all the coaches, all the players on each level, man. They brought it like a town out there.
Man, they had Bebe and them under the tents with the Monroe.
Oh, my God.
Q called me, said, yo, they got Bebe over under here with Monroe coaches. I said, tell them. I said, get the fuck over here. They got a cooler.
But this is the funny part.
That's all you need.
Look, but this is the funny part, bro. Bebe hiding. I'm talking to Tim. I'm like, Tim, what are you doing over here? You're here partying with these people.
Yo, baby,
you played him in 3 weeks. I'm like, yo, he in the cut like this, chilling. I said, no, I'm calling you. I said, watch. She's like, he right here. I'm like, you off the slide.
You're done.
Anybody that played Monroe, Terrence got the real smoke this year. He got the thick.
Man, I was mad.
He got the thick smoke, and that joint go forever.
He had
the NFL smoke. You know how they come on commercial and the field still smoking. At the motherfucking kickoff, Nuggets still couldn't see out that motherfucker. I said, God, Lee, where you get this motherfucker from? The Patriots?
Yeah, he got a 200 box of them. He got 200 of them. He got it for cancer.
This motherfucker dropping bombs with attitude. It's like, hey, motherfucker, get that shit out my field. You literally got an attitude with me.
I mean, I got my bag. I got my motherfucking executive board member bag. I'm off in the field like, that smoke was supposed to cost the 40.
Exactly.
Yeah, this guy is the wrong person to give some power to.
Facts. Yo, I said, yo, he was. That smoke once was across the 40, but I seen it. Fuck that.
Yeah, the cheerleaders breathing all the smoke in. Parents getting in their cheese fries and fried fish.
I'm like, man, come on, man. This is too many motherfuckers. They done popped the smoke talking to the kids at the end of the game and shit. I'm like, what the fuck?
That's funny as hell.
That's the blue smoke.
But yeah, I want to really give a shout out because a lot of them kids play slime. They mess with this man. So just out of respect, we talked a lot of shit before that. So we never want to let people think we're taking it personal or nothing. We talk shit, but it's still football. You know what I mean?
Facts, facts.
So shout out to all my Monroe people from top to bottom.
Fuck all the Monroe people.
From top to bottom.
He could not wait for Q to stop talking to say that. He was at the mic like this.
And George.
From top to bottom.
George, the reason I showed him so much
from
love.
Frank to smoke, from Frank to motherfucking.
They think we hate us. From Frank to all the mass.
From Frank to Mike McQuarrie. Nigga.
Yeah, you get cut off the board. You ain't go to the meeting tonight. That he's talking about. Right,
yo, shout out to my cheerleaders too,
nigga. I don't want to do no motherfucking registrations ever again.
Shout out to my Wolfpack cheerleaders too, man. They was out there showing us love. My girl Kelly and the rest of the gang. They wanted to shout out tonight. So shout out to my Wolfpack cheerleaders for showing us love, for sure.
Man,
what up, Chris?
So man, let's go to the
next game.
Let's go to Whitman and
we only on the second game.
We only on the second game, but y'all be laughing too much, bro. let's go to Whitman and Bridgeton, freshman.
They got poop emojis. Anything with Bridgeton get the poop emojis?
Yeah,
this week.
Man, that's it.
Cam said he want to know why I hate Monroe so bad.
It's because he got to go to meetings at 7:30 in the morning.
I don't hate Monroe. I just dislike you.
Dislike you.
Nah, because y'all was talking shit, nigga.
Maybe stalking you.
I leave the game if I was called me. Monroe just pulled up here talking about they beating Deford ass this year. I was like, what?
That's every year.
They still worried about me. That's what got their ass beat week one last year.
Nah, we got to start with the 6-year and Whitman part.
If
you don't, they're gonna harass you. Good lord! But I did see some film of them. Them motherfuckers are crazy. They was running wing team.
They like an actual.
Counters.
They like an actual, like a 7-8. You know what I mean? Yeah. They run actual plays.
They was running the plays.
They all right.
That's your yeah. That
yeah, was I right. I seen the tape on them too. They some dogs, man.
Does UIFL have a 6-year division either for?
I believe they do.
So they can go down there. Yeah, win a championship.
I think so.
That's dope. That's good, Whitman Park.
Look, yeah. Didn't I tell you these Bridgeton people keep tagging?
What did he say?
Pender, wasn't you just in Violent? He said, get in the lab.
Don't he still got a kid in Violent?
They in Bridgeton. Yeah. But we picked 40 on his
Pender,
head.
Yeah. Pender got a start at 9.
Pender got 100 sons.
Mm-hmm. And we always put 100 points on him in 2 years.
Nah, his kids is athletes.
His kids is good. His son was good. He's only one to make tackles.
Yeah, his kids is athletes.
Everybody else is chasing diving ducks. What are you talking about?
Diving ducks.
George was like, yeah, he's out of there. Niggas is chasing.
Yeah, well.
We're on the Whitman Park now. I don't want to talk about
that. We're on the Whitman Park. Hey, that 6-year, man. Shout out to them boys. They crazy as all hell, but them motherfuckers.
Somebody said they gotta be bad as hell. It's bad as hell.
Oh man.
He said I got kids involved in Bridgeton.
Bridgeton 6-year not bad though. They held their own. They held their own with them.
Yeah.
But I think Deffern 6-year got something for them when they show up to Deffern, that's all I'm gonna say. We ain't have practice today. I went over there, checked out the freshman 6-year got something over there, man.
Ain't Lex the coach over there?
Nah, Lex ain't the coach.
I thought she was the coach.
You really thought she was the coach? Nah, Lex ain't.
I'm serious. I thought Lex was the coach.
Nah, we was just fucking around. I said, Lex, oh, I'm getting your ass on the podcast. I heard some shit about you. And she looked at me like, what? I was like, nah, I'm fucking with you. She's like, oh, nigga, shit, I've been outside a little bit.
I was like, I know. What the fuck is
that? What have you outside a little bit?
I said, I'm out of the rock a little bit. Without you.
Yeah.
shit.
Go ahead and share the podcast, y'all. Let's get it up. Let's get it up to 100.
Yeah, let's get it up to
100.
Y'all
been
looking at that.
Let's get it up to 100 viewers, y'all. Come on, 100 live viewers.
Yeah,
share it out on your page. It's public.
Damn, that's dope. I've been looking at it on the low, like that shit just creeping.
Yo, so so Brixton, man, Brixton Whitman. Whitman come out with a big win, man. I'm hearing some good things about Whitman Park.
Coach Nas.
Yeah, Coach Nas, he slime. That's why they won, Coach.
Yeah, slime. We got to take credit for that. Whitman.
Yeah. Hold up. And I got to give an apology because he ran down on me at the game. One of their coaches, Kevin Black, he ran down on me and said, yo, on the podcast, you picked Brixton. I'm like, oh, brother.
I picked Brixton, too.
Yo. Much love to Whitman Park 8U, my boy Nas, Narcy, man.
Yep.
Much love, my guy. Way to get that good victory.
Yeah, bro. Yo, listen. Coach Nas is the only one who listen. I've been telling coaches to DM me. Best player, offense and defense. He's the only one. So we're going to give a shout out to his 8U players.
Yeah, Whitman Park 8U.
So players of the week for Whitman Park 8U is running back Marquis Williams, number one. And defensive tackle Gavin Collins, number 99.
Yeah, give it up for them boys.
Good
job, fellas. Good work.
Pretend to say we ain't slime.
Come on.
Damn, Pender, you got a son in Pittsgrove? Why? How the fuck you make it to all them?
Hold on. He said that?
That's all you hear. Pender on top. God damn. This thing is crazy.
Oh my God. All around Cumberland County.
How the fuck you gonna get to them games?
quarter each. Yeah, each of y'all get a quarter.
Yeah. Let me know who got the best cheese fries.
Oh man.
That ain't gonna be a lot of films this year.
I'ma say something too this year. Y'all know me and Ooze do a lot of concession stand reviews. It's been horrible.
Do not talk about my fish.
Your food's been horrible.
Don't talk about my fish. Whatever you do.
It's been horrible.
Listen, man.
Yo, the Paulsboro game. Paulsboro week.
Hold on.
Some good food.
Pause.
We already went over that game.
We already went over that. I tried these new Spartan fries today at the field. Good night.
I knew they're nasty. Who would eat that?
Bro. When I tell y'all go to Deffer and ask for the Spartan fries, telling you, goodness gracious.
If I come there and y'all award ain't hung up in the concession stand, you'll never get it again.
You better talk to Lex. I don't know what she
got
doing
hung up in her room.
Where we at?
Oh, Brixton. What you talking about, Sean?
Brixton, we had to
tell you.
We had to tell you. Who won that game? Brixton.
And I picked Whitman Park.
You was hyping Whitman Park 10U up.
That was a clue. It was a one possession game.
Q was hyping Whitman up.
It was a one possession game. Brixton's supposed to blow Whitman out.
Yo, keep sharing, peoples. Keep sharing.
Q was impressed with Whitman.
Well, I told you I scrimmaged them early in the year, and none of them big ass kids they had on the team was on that team because we ran muck on them. So when I seen them this year, I was like, oh man, they got a big quarterback. Last year, quarterback had a lot of gear on, couldn't move.
All right, so that we go to Brixton and Whitman 12U.
And yeah.
That was a big, lot
big
of talk.
A lot of talk.
Man. That was one of the games of the week.
I had Whitman.
George picked Whitman.
Yo, Kato, stop talking about my fish, man.
That shit was tuna.
I bought two flatters.
This nigga Q said, cuz, you want a piece? I looked down, I'm like, hell yeah, I want a piece. I was like,
nah, cuz, I ain't putting no season on this, cuz. That shit. He said, they ain't seasoning it, cuz. I was like, nah, he's throwing hot sauce in. I was like, oh,
he damn. Had shake a bagel.
I had to wash that motherfucker down with the bread. I'm sorry, whoever made it. Cuz they must have ran out of the motherfucker.
stick with cooking fried chicken.
Yes. Right. We was good with the Harvey chicken. I don't know what happened. Man.
Listen.
I don't know what happened with that shit.
Whoop Barry's fried chicken. It was one of the worst contagions in a long time. They took that motherfucker straight out the motherfucker Delaware River and threw that bitch in the grease.
Get the oil water still.
That's funny. Damn.
I gave away two platters and they gave them back.
That shit was terrible.
Charges $16 for it.
That shit was terrible. Ain't got any motherfucking salt and
you
pepper.
You embarrassed me in front of my friends.
They ain't had no salt and pepper or nothing on that mother. They just said no. They ain't no motherfucking nothing. They ain't no motherfucking liars or nothing on that motherfucker. No garlic powder or nothing on that motherfucker.
Nah, really
six more viewers. Six more viewers, guys. Get that shit popping. We trying to reach 100 viewers.
Get to the
100. It was a
diabetic
fish.
I'm
telling you,
I don't know what it was going over there. Hey, get fix that shit. Oh,
that ain't us.
I got it.
You
know,
behind CVS, that little piece of water back there.
Oh, that's disgusting.
You put that over by the CVS.
That creek. Oh, hell.
That little creek back there, motherfucker.
That's disgusting.
Ain't that but a bunch of sunnies back there.
Oh man!
Listen, we're gonna tell you if you can sustain. No, I'm good. Yeah, we're gonna tell you about
that. Goes to show you, us Puerto Ricans ain't make that shit.
Yeah, definitely wasn't no adobo on that. Yeah, but there was a lot of talk with that Bridgeton and Whitman. Mm-hmm. You know, my boy.
Did it live up to the hype?
C Dub and the boy. Did it live up to the hype?
Yeah. Because sometimes the score don't explain the game, and they said that they. They control the whole game, and you know what I mean?
So from what I seen, I was at that game. I got there. I got there. It was already 6 or 7. Nothing. I don't know what the field 6 or 7. But from what I saw, Whitman is struggling big time offensively. Mm. They got to try to figure out, you know, losing some key players, losing their best offensive weapon for the season. Speaking of injuries, man, let's everybody send my boy Wes some prayers, man. He tore his ACL, MCL.
Damn.
Yeah, man. He down, man. His dad spoke to me. He was like, man, let everybody know, you know what I'm saying, situation. So, well, it ain't like I'm just throwing it out there. His boss reached out to me. So, he's like, man, make sure you let everybody know, man. Shout out to, man, send my boy Wes some prayers, man. Once in a lifetime talent that kid has, man. So, hopefully, man.
Hopefully be ready next year for you, right?
He can bounce
well
back.
Soon, man.
But Whitman Park losing their top two offensive weapons from last year, it's obvious that they're struggling offensively right now to even have an identity. Their defense is going to keep them in games because it's going to be still tough to score on them. Mm. But Bristol definitely controlled that game.
Mm. And that was just second half.
Was it some click clacking going on?
Yeah, it was some hitting, but
Bridgeton physical.
Bridgeton has a really good defense, bro. And I told them on a live the other day, I'm like, I wasn't gonna tell y'all to do it, but about time y'all put number 10 in the backfield. He was always at tight end, mm-hmm. but you can tell he fast as shit at linebacker. He can cover the whole field at mm-hmm. middle linebacker, and he's physical. But you can tell he never played running back before. So as the year goes on, he's gonna get a lot better running the football. So. Bristol is going to be all right, man. If they can get it together offensively, Bristol struggled a little bit offensively, but they were definitely able to move the ball versus Whitman. So we're going to see how they look versus Woodbury this week because Woodbury's not a slouch. So we're going to see how that game goes. I think that's going to be a tight game this week.
Bristol and Woodbury.
Bristol and Woodbury.
They beat us pretty bad last year.
I was going to say that's going to be a two touchdown game.
If we can take the hitting, we'd be all right.
I think this year they was cracking.
I don't know. This guy wants to take the hitting.
Yo, y'all had to see what I saw, yo.
I seen his face.
Yo, he just noticed it.
Whoa. Oh my God!
I heard it real low.
I tried to let it go.
You want me to say he was laying wood?
We can take the hitting. And then we can get it back.
That's what George said. George said, we going to take it and we going to give it back with pressure.
Yeah,
come on,
man.
Hey, yo. Yeah, we need 100 viewers, man.
Take the crack.
Shout us out. We need 100 viewers.
We only on the second game.
All right, man.
All right, bro. All right, bro.
Let's go to Deford and Paul's, bro.
Here you go.
He gonna make sure we don't skip that segment.
I should have waited a week to come on to the show.
Until after. Let's get a double card, bro, man. We got George took Paul's bro 8U. You took Paul's bro 8U?
I took Paul's bro all the way through.
I don't know who I picked.
You picked Paul's bro.
No, I picked
Paul's bro. O picked Deford.
Yeah, I picked Deford.
Q picked with Paul's bro. I mean, every pick we was picking different.
I think he was mad at Deford.
Shout out to Paul's bro 8U though. They was bringing it. That was my favorite game of the weekend that I saw so far.
That was a really good game.
Shout out to my boy Kai.
It was exciting.
My boy Juju.
It was an exciting game. I love number 7 from Paul's bro.
Yeah.
I think that kid has a bright future. What's his name again?
Kai Mears.
Yeah.
That's Inky's son, right?
Yeah, he stepped up a lot.
Shout out to him, man. He was bringing it. Even if it was 5 yards, 10 yards, he was putting his helmet down.
How do PT keep testing me, man? I wish PT was on the show.
I told you
to
give me his spot on the board.
I wish. You might get it, Q, because he's tripping.
Yo, leave my coach alone.
Once he went to Deford, you might as well get rid of him. I would have got rid of him.
Oh, stop it.
I'm telling you, George.
Don't hand me that motherfucker.
Yeah, let me get one.
Nah, nigga, you opened that with a Cowboys opener. Give me that lighter over there. Nothing to do with Cowboys.
Yeah, right. You see that number? That number one defense Sunday night.
You got one of them, George. There's one more in there.
Seen that number one defense Sunday night.
Yeah, we never gonna get through this show.
Hell no.
Yeah, we gonna get through. So, what the fuck? Oh, we talking about Paul's, bro. Shout out to Carter Redman with the only touchdown of the game.
Yeah, that was big.
My boy scored on
that
first carry.
Moving.
I'm about to go take a break during this section. I got to get to the bathroom.
Carter Redman, shout out to that young man. I don't know who his dad is. God damn it, that kid's getting raised the right way.
Yeah, and that was good. And I know that hurt for Paulsburg, though, for the only touchdown to be by him, too.
Nah, that ain't hurt. You know what I mean? It was some people. I ain't hurt.
Man, people were rude. Yo, so I was on the phone today. I don't want people to say people's name. And I was like, man, Carter hit that corner. I know they was mad over there. He was like, man. Man, everybody was over there, but was cheering when that motherfucker.
He turned the corner.
Everybody was standing over there, but was cheering when he hit the end zone.
You know what I mean? You from Paulsburg? Yeah, we had people over there cheering for Lil Warner. You know what I mean? If you from Paulsburg and play for somewhere else, people still going to cheer for you.
For sure.
And it's all love at the end of the day. We talk hella stuff to each other, but you know what I mean. It ain't nothing.
For sure, that's love.
Yeah, man. But shout out to. The whole Deford 8U, though, man. And shout out to the coaching staff for getting them boys ready. That's a tough game, week 1.
Yeah.
That's not an easy out. So that was the most exciting game. That was one of the games of the weeks.
Yeah, right.
Sure. With them, Whitman and Bristol and Monroe and Woodbury.
Yeah. Shout out to both of them coaching staffs, man.
Yeah. So, both of them teams have a bright future going ahead.
Mike said lies, y'all be on.
Yeah,
that's because Mike, you from the borough. You came over there with Woodbury colors on, and y'all wasn't playing.
Yeah, you gotta share my boys with love.
I said you gotta wear white. That's neutral. You know what I mean? That's a little bit of Woodbury.
Yeah, Woodbury colors on again.
Yeah, blue on.
That's my guy. He's all the way in. He's all the way in.
Oswald?
Yeah.
He's a dun. He's a ham. Oh, there you go. I couldn't see the comments. Mike, you're done. You're a fucking ham sandwich.
Nah, I got your back, Mike.
You don't go to fucking
Mike posted a video for the Jay Marie playing Paul's bro. I said, Mike, take that down. I got you. You'll never be able to go back, son.
Macklin'll have many more highlights this year, don't worry. Macklin going through for at least, I'm gonna say, 15 touchdowns this year.
Yeah.
I'm gonna say Macklin going through for 15 touchdowns this year.
Yeah, for sure.
Moving on to that sophomore game. Lord Jesus, were they confident? Oh my God, it don't get no more confident than when they came and stepped on the field.
Nah,
I said,
Oh my God, Matt Eclipse came on there, told the kids, "You too slow, you a bum."
No, he didn't. No, he didn't. What? I missed that.
Because Matt was on the field, talk man. Then Bundy got on the field. Cash Money, he told Stevie, "You can't do shit in big games. We watched you lose 40 to nothing in the championship.
Oh,
you stink." Oh. I was like, "God damn, these niggas got." I was like, "Yo." Cuz I ain't never seen a coach is so confident in my life. They ain't have no chance of winning.
The coach ain't supposed to be confident?
Yeah, they're talking crazy.
The coach ain't supposed to be confident.
Bro, if that was me, I said, "You'll get beat by 30." They took that shit personal.
They had no chance at winning that game, I'm telling you. The way they came out talking to these people, I thought they wanted to fight. I was like, I don't know if I'd have been able to take that.
Yeah. They say you ain't do nothing.
You bigger. Too slow. Your mom fat. I was like, "Yeah, yo, damn."
They trash.
Yo, yo, I was like, "Jesus Christ, Clips, chill out."
What you think? You supposed to come out there and lay down?
Yeah. What? I'm like, bro. I started telling all the kids, like, "Look, man, they can't talk them into no win." Yo, these though they was talking crazy. I see what now. I understand why they was throwing the ball with 23 seconds left. Rub that shit in.
You wouldn't even think this guy from Ballsburg. Huh? You wouldn't even think this guy from Ballsburg.
Hey, but what you want me to do? They was talking too much.
Go on to the next game.
Julius,
Man, shout out to the shout out to the defensive sophomore staff, man, bouncing back, man, and getting them nice big win, man.
They needed that.
Paul Gaul's a good team. Paul Gaul's a good team.
We're going to the junior, to the 12. You can't help.
Paul Gaul has a good sophomore team. They're going to be all right. They're young. They're going to be all right.
If that was a 9U team, it ain't nobody around here that can mess.
Yeah, they got a promise.
Yeah, they keep their 9U team. I'm going to take all their 10s and bring them with me.
They got a promise.
It's five of them.
Yeah, I'm going to bring all five of them with me. Not two.
To the junior game.
They're not playing on Slime U Fall next year.
Yes, they are.
And the Yellow Beach.
We're going to the Yellow Beach.
And the Yellow Beach.
Exactly. It's Sweet Family.
To the 12.
Yeah, what up, G?
What y'all want to do about the 12 year?
Y'all went to the senior game. We're going to go into the senior game. We had two new coaches on the seniors.
I know, Q.
We had Joey, Eli, and K out there coaching in the senior game.
Hold on, you're a visitor.
Hold on,
right. We got some junior game.
Yo, lucky I'm on this show today. I respect that.
My cousin Calvin told me keep my name out of his mouth on this corny ass podcast.
Yeah, he did, bro.
He then proceeded to tell me I was a trash ass coach.
You stink.
And I fucking suck. I said, "Tell me how you really feel, cuz." He said, "I just did. Nigga, you fucking suck."
I told Q, I said,
"I don't argue with Calvin because he's going to make you want to fight him, man. And he's going to be having a great day for the rest of the day. Yes, you'll be in your house cussing your kids out because Calvin just pissed you off."
My God.
Yeah, I was good, man. Yeah. He was going back and forth with me because I was laughing at the shit. And I didn't take it serious. And then the damn basketball coach said something to me.
You wanted to really fight Calvin.
No, I did. That was the first time.
But this is the second time. I'm enjoying it now.
Y'all got a little too serious.
Oh, I want to fight. I want to fight.
Why Darius say that this line, you niggas is snakes?
He's still mad about Myrtle Beach.
What happened?
Freaking couple of the players on basketball team, which they was only in the practice session. They wasn't even in games yet. They was only practicing. We never tell high school kids to come to Slime U when you got high school. It's track, no matter what you're doing. High school first. They said, "Fuck basketball, they coming to Myrtle Beach." We hear they show up. That's not my problem. I would never tell a kid to skip a high school.
You should have told him to go to practice, kid.
Hell no. we was all over. What's that joint on YouTube? What's that shit?
With the hero?
Nah, what's the YouTube video joint? Of all the games.
I know you.
Generation X.
Nope, not the other one.
Dang. You know the when we was playing versus Cam Newton and them.
Yeah. What's the joint called? Damn, I can't think right now. I do all the national high school games, but it was on one of the main YouTube pages. You know what I mean? And the kids knew that, so they knew they was gonna be there. They was trying to be at that scene and be on there. And they really, we was kicking ass. We got put on the map that day.
Yeah, high school basketball.
Yeah, we did.
Went toe to toe with Cam Newton out there that day.
Under the radar.
Under the radar.
We was on under the radar. So that's all the kids knew. We were under the radar. We're going down there. You know what I mean?
We had 98, though.
No, sure. We almost had 100.
There we go. There go the 100 right there.
Yeah. So,
congratulations.
Shout out to Clock, man. Shout out, man. We got 100 viewers.
That's our first 100 viewer.
Shout out to the Yellow
Episode 11.
James going to go live tomorrow and say the reason why we have.
if you ever want your views to go, just bring the Yellow Pages on. They're going to skyrocket.
I'm going to share this to my fan page. I got 60,000 followers on that.
There you go.
Shit. Hell yeah.
Nah, I put it on my personal page. You cheating and putting it on your fan page.
I put it on my personal page today for the first time. I'll normally just share it.
He said, you know, what's my prize?
Yo.
That's what's up, y'all.
But the senior game, man. Let's go to the Death Row Paul Rowe senior game. Very good game, man.
New coaches out there.
Shout out to the Paul's bro, new coaches. I think they actually did a pretty good job, but being able to one even putting the team together.
Rick Eli's son. I'm not to cut you off, Isaac, but that team started out with, I'm gonna say, 7 players. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? And he went out and just picked up players. I think they up to like 16 players now.
They don't have
a quarterback over there. They don't have running backs over there. You know what I mean? He learned from his pops.
Somebody was running that ball. Yeah, somebody was out there. They could run a little bit.
But it ain't nobody that was playing running back coming up to the scene. You know what I mean? Just somebody that's got speed on there, and they put him back there. So shout out to Joey Eli, Rick's son.
Yeah, that's much love, much love. We all start somewhere. You got to take your bumps and bruises. Hold on,
y'all see my mom comment?
What's up,
mom? Love you. enjoy your time down Atlantic City. She on her little sister's vacation.
That's precious,
his twin. Oh, you ain't take me out to? I like to gamble. Roulette. 529. Bet on that.
That's dope.
Yo, so I think that was a very interesting game with Paul's Brawl Death Ray. It was a close game. I think it was still 0-0 in the fourth quarter. And shout out to my boy, man, Manny Jones.
0-0 in the fourth quarter?
Yeah.
He said that they're the Bad News Bears.
Huh?
He just said they was the Bad News Bears.
Kay was talking crazy heavy on there, saying they stink. The players was coming there playing for him, and it's 0-0 in the fourth quarter.
He said, who stink?
Kay on the dark side with me. Kay was the only coach I was cool with in Denver. Fuck all y'all. It was Kay and the cheese fries. That's the only thing I fucked with in Denver. Kay got on a live out of nowhere and started talking crazy.
Live.
I want to say it was with Twerk one day.
Oh, man.
And he started talking crazy. That's the twerk effect.
That's the twerk effect, man.
Kay started talking crazy, good dude. Kay cool, man.
Man, love for Kay, man. That's my dog.
They dedicated to it.
Oh, shout out to our sponsorships. Much love to our sponsorships.
And we got a few of them, man. So
yeah, but Manny Jones, man, he came out and scored the 2 touchdowns in the fourth quarter. They gotta get the ball in Manny Jones' hands, man. He played for me a couple times when our kids were like the young age. He was one of the only older kids on the team. Then he went over to Winslow, and now he's back in Deffer. But they gotta figure out a way to get that kid the ball more, man. He's explosive.
Yeah, I see the work they putting in on Deffer 14 years. So glad to see it's paying off. You know what I mean? It's a process.
I told Frank Cooper that's the team that is gonna sneak into the playoffs and create havoc.
Oh, Deffer. Hey, man, Deffer gonna be all right, man.
Deffer what?
14U.
I left at halftime.
I think it's gonna be violent.
Violent made the playoffs.
I'm
last
not
year.
Saying they're gonna be the sleeper team. I think in the senior.
Yeah,
level.
Listen, man.
I don't think nobody's sleeping on them. You can't sleep on a team with a kid like Georgia.
But the line isn't great over that line. Yeah, that line
nothing's
isn't great at all.
They better. How many Penders is on that, my brother?
4.5.
How you get a half? I want to hear that one.
Maybe.
Yeah. Four to pump.
Four to pump.
Man, let's talk about Kingsway and Sterling.
We knew nothing about Kingsway last week. Man. Nothing.
I mean, at 8U.
We know a little bit about the 8U.
Right, well.
That 8U is not all that they're cracked up that people think they are. They were pretty. They got They were pretty good last year.
So
because
Reggie just put hype behind them?
I just think we trust Reggie.
Without Rippey, they go down a notch, man. Rippey was pretty much the workhorse for them last year when he got one over there with Reggie, but he's not there. Lil Reggie's a dog. Lil Reggie's good, but I'm just saying.
I'm saying they're a good team.
I
seen his ass.
Yeah, I'm saying they're a good team, but I don't think that they're. I think that they get beat by a Paulsboro. You know what I'm saying?
All right.
That's in my. You know, but you know the game still got to be.
Oh yeah, Paulsboro. Paulsboro AU is top. They got to be. Where we got them at?
I don't know. They took a loss, so they dropped a little bit.
Yeah, but they really Paulsboro 8 years is probably a top five team.
Everything
that defense is crazy.
That defense
everything
is crazy.
Everything worked itself out once everybody played each other. But you know, as of right now, you know the rankings is coming soon.
But the AU is going to be a lot of upsets. It's going to be a lot of close games. A lot of one possession games in the AU this year. I think really that's the most exciting.
That's good. That's good level. For our, that's good for our league
because that means in the coming
right. That means it's competitive.
I've been paying attention to that. It's like it sucks that I'm all the way in 14U. But looking at all the younger teams, I'm like, man, that shit going to just come up. And eventually it's going to turn.
People
going to
bounce around. Mm. You know, once the bounce, we still got to get to the point of going down the Nationals, a championship team, winning, going down there, playing.
No, I agree with that.
Stuff that goes on after that, we all the drama, the BS, you know what I mean? It's always.
That's why we stick to slime.
This is the craziest free agency year, I'll tell you that much. This shit was crazy.
It was a crazy free agency year.
People are still moving. Yeah. Yellow Pages registration doesn't close until the 15th. Listen, people are still moving.
I just got a call.
I got a call. Cousin Ram, you can come back
anytime. Did you see him score against the Dark Knights?
No. I won't watch
anytime.
He scored against the Dark Knights. Nice touchdown.
Yeah. I won't watch it.
Yeah. It breaks his heart.
Shout out to Lil Cuz out there, man.
Yeah. Shout out. That's my dog. He was at all my games.
I think he scored a 60-yard touchdown.
Nuh-uh.
Yeah.
See, I can't take that.
Well, let's fly through these games.
All right. Let's fly through these games.
We got Sterling and Kingsway 8U. Kingsway.
I heard that was a pretty good game.
I heard it was a good game. It was a good game. It was a good game. It was actually a tough game for Kingsway. Like I said, I don't think they're as dominant as people think they're going to be.
Right.
Think they're going to take a couple, you know, more than a couple losses once they get to the, you know, harder part of their schedule.
They was talking crazy. Sterling told them they was going to beat them by 3 touchdowns on the loss.
Sometimes Sterling just be talking. Forgot that they're Sterling.
What about that sophomore game?
Skip.
Juniors.
Yeah,
this is what it sounds like when we were doing the rankings.
If I don't know what you're doing between 6 to 8, we're not talking about you.
No, man.
I don't know what you guys are doing between 6 to 8.
Man, who won?
Sterling.
Sterling won on the sophomores?
That's
Sterling's sophomore team ain't bad.
Sterling's sophomore team isn't, but they weren't bad last year.
Yeah. Why weren't they? They was bad.
I was on the sideline.
You played them last year?
47 nothing.
Yeah.
Everybody forgets that we picked 40 on them. That was a 40-piece nugget. That's why I was like, Denver was struggling with him until halftime.
Y'all stunk anyway.
Look, other than the big dogs, y'all was the only ones that played as close. It was 14. Everybody else was 30.
And that last play y'all scored, I called some BS just to try something real quick to get the ball back and cause confusion, and y'all wind up scoring. So
had to ride that horse.
That touchdown was a BS touchdown.
Riding that horse. Pause.
Oh my God.
Oh my God.
And the bad part about it, he said it twice. He said it first and then said it again to make sure it was dirty.
He
said it twice.
What did he say? He was riding
I'll make sure y'all hear it.
Did he just say he's riding that horse?
Twice.
This guy is out of control. Can we get a ref to give me a flag so I can start throwing flags on these North niggas? That's a personal fucking foul.
I'm done with the corona.
That is a personal foul. That's unsportsmanlike.
Yo, Isaac just paused. Like, I know this nigga. Yes.
But he said it twice.
That is a fucking
make sure these guys here.
That is a game ball foul, man. Golly.
They ain't here the first time.
Right.
Yo, bro, man, you coached in the early 2000s, man. You see anything, man.
Yikes.
He says a flagrant one,
I'm riding that horse. He said, you hear me? I'm riding that horse.
He ain't even save it for the pause section. For the pause segment. Oh, shit. Unbelievable.
He's like, I took a lap.
Yeah. No. Oh shit!
That ain't some shit you gotta take a laugh for. Get out! So I'm ready
for up downs.
Get him chopping.
Oh man!
So Sterling Kingsway Jr.'s. I heard Jaden Bush was at one with one carry, 60 yards, touchdown.
Nah, I see more than that.
Huh?
I see more than that.
No, I'm just saying. I said at one point I just seen something like post.
No, but I said people were saying that. Yeah, people were saying that though. Like he only had one carry. I seen some highlights. He looked pretty good against them.
Yeah, Jaden Boyce is a beast, man. That's a good pickup for Sterling.
Not enough.
Not enough?
Not that you're not in American. Mm. Maybe if they was international still, definitely, but not in American.
And that's not the only piece that Ben got, though. I think it's enough to beat a lot of teams.
It's not about that. When you got to say who's the top in our division is, do we have enough to beat them?
Yeah. I don't know. I'm not gonna speak on that, but I think they're going to beat Whitman this week.
Ooh.
Mm. Oh, oh, oh. I think they're going to beat Whitman.
Is that a shot at Cotty, or you just think? What you think?
It's not Cotty's team.
It's not. How can you put a shot at him? He doesn't do nothing.
I'm not.
I'm asking the question.
I don't even want to say his name on the podcast.
That's my dog, man. That's my guy.
Man, listen. I just think they're going to beat Whitman. That's just my honest, as a coach, as a guy watching football. I think they're going to beat them. They're going to start out 0-2. Now, if they don't.
Lowe's been quiet, too. Lowe's ain't been on here.
Lowe's is on the Ben Franklin right now.
That's what it is. Where you at, Lowe's?
Lowe's live, talking, commenting. I haven't seen Lowe's in a while.
He's been quiet for
about a minute. That might be a good thing. Lowe's might be in the lab, man.
When you lose, you got to get your ass in the lab.
That's much respect. That's much
respect. Might be in the lab right now.
That's much respect.
Nobody beating Defer 12, yeah.
We know that.
That might be.
We know that.
That might be some type of truth to that.
Man, the only thing that matters is what is Defer going to do down in Florida?
Oh, man.
That's what matters.
It remind me to not put this guy on the show no more.
What are they going to do in Florida?
He always want to skip. He swears that I'm going to beat me.
I ask the questions that don't want to be asked.
We gonna go down there and put in work like we always do.
All right, thanks for the answer.
You gonna do what?
Put in work.
Don't try to pause.
He looking for anything, nigga. You the one out here riding ponies, nigga.
What's the next game, man?
All right, man, that's it. All right, man, Millville, Willenboro, man, that was a good win for Millville.
Sweet.
Good win for real. If we don't know what you're doing from 6 to 8, let them go.
What's the music when the Sandman used to come out on the pilot? When somebody gets sweep, you gotta play that. You gotta put the Sandman.
All right, we'll find it right now so we can give it to
Paul. What are you doing from 6 p.m. to 8 p.m.?
Oh, you better not find that.
I'm gonna find that.
I'm leaving.
With the Sandman?
Yeah, I'm out, yo. All right, let's get my stuff.
bring him out.
Oh, yo, man. All right, man. But I thought that Willenboro Millville game had the makings to be a good game. I think Millville won like 21-0.
Yeah, 20-0. I heard.
What the boy from Willenboro do?
Obviously nothing. If it was 20-0,
he could have broken 40 yards.
I don't know. Millville held him in check.
So they was the main ones mad about the rankings. We should be higher. You pit up a donut.
You didn't score.
We ain't crossed that line.
You didn't score.
They said, well, after week one, y'all going to see what Willenboro, you went down a little bit. Rocky, you can't win.
That's why it takes so long.
I ain't see the mugshot. What the mugshot people was talking about, man? I ain't see that shit, bro.
And now we got mugshots in the league.
Nah, from the college team or some shit.
What we next?
But anyway, what we got, man? That's it.
We ain't done with, yeah, skip through them. Any other good games?
Nah, that was it.
All right, get rid of the bums.
All right, man, we got our next segment. What's this segment sponsored by, bro?
Man, this segment is sponsored by AKA Booms Concrete, man. And we will be doing our rankings.
Are we going to rankings?
Yeah, let's get the rankings out the way.
All right, man, we got our rankings, man.
So we could just fly through them.
All right, we're going to fly through the rankings. We're going to start at 8U. This is Tri-County rankings.
Tri-County only. Tri-County only right now. We love everybody, but...
You know, oh, this boy. Is...
We love everybody, man.
All right. Cracking the lineup for the first time. Wasn't on the list last week at number 10 for 8U. We got Glassboro.
Yeah,
we got Glassboro. Glassboro. Give it up for Glassboro. All right. At number 9, we got Clayton. Clayton.
Clayton and Glassboro in that top 10.
All right. At number 8, Willenboro dropped the spot to go down to that 8 spot, you know, after that loss. At number 7, we got Bridgeton. They dropped from last week after that loss. Who they lose to? Whitman, right?
Whitman Park.
Come on, Dez. You know we ain't got no FJI spot. At number 6, we got Paulsboro. Even though they lost, man, we know that Paulsboro is a good team.
They lost to another top 10 team.
At number 5, we got Kingsway. Kingsway at 5, man. Paulsboro should be able to maybe jump over top of them in a one-on-one matchup. Number 4, we got Whitman. Whitman jumped up with that big win over Bridgeton. Good job to Whitman and that staff. We already shout out our boy Nas. Mm-hmm. At 3, we got Defford.
Mm-hmm.
And here comes the shakeup.
Monroe or Millville?
After a heated conversation on the phone,
yep.
Today it was. This is a four person panel. There is no computers involved.
PT all right. Angry. PT was in there.
Some people think, and that there were some mistakes made, possibly going off of this week one. The number 2 spot this week goes to Monroe. Millville goes and regains its number 1 spot at the top right now in Tri-County.
Because that was pretty hard last week. We was really debating. That was probably the hardest pick.
But right, the fact it's because that you know what Monroe has, but you got to respect Millville for winning the championship. Yeah,
got to respect them. You got to beat them to get.
And they put a donut against a top 10 team.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
I got Millville Bummer
when I ranked. Who paid y'all? All
right.
Good looking, Rip. Yeah. All right. Top 10. Not 10 you, I'm sorry.
10 Woodbury 1.
Woodbury is 11.
10 you. Number 10. Paulsboro. This nigga Q is crazy, bro.
You know we got to walk outside with this podcast over, right?
Pause, bro.
You tripping, right?
At 9, we got the GT Lions.
The GT Lions is better than Pause.
Hell, y'all trying to play in my face right. So y'all really trying to play in my face right now, right?
Hey, yeah.
No, this what y'all brought me on the show for, Adam?
Yo, accept at your own risk.
It's 3 against 1 right now.
No, you gotta blame these niggas. These niggas and PT.
Blame these niggas and PT, bro.
Man, we will blow GT's doors. GT ain't never. We will blow GT's doors off. Y'all just trying to be funny. They probably don't even say that on there.
Bro, I swear, I don't even know how these niggas came up with this.
Where do you even get the GT Lions from? Y'all did this because I was on the show.
Let's look at the scores left. And you got to understand, bro, because T's logic and rankings is like almost like Gotti's, bro. Them niggas lost. Them niggas won. So why then they should be up there. I'll be like,
The scrimmage against us. When we scrimmage GT, we probably beat GT about five touchdowns to zero, but they had a pick or two. We scored six out of eight times against.
Now you see why it's who talks GT. Let's get to the
that's why GT went up there.
So we got GT Lions at number nine.
But we took the best running
just
back.
Like y'all said, just like y'all said, Lindenwald is good. Back. Just like they said, y'all said Lindenwald tenure was good. That's what Paulsberg did to him.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Oh, that's the dumbness y'all talking. Bad week to come to the show.
A horrible week. We got
we're going to bring you back next week. We're going to bring you back next week.
Hold on. So you said Paulsberg did Lindenwald dirty in the scrimmage?
Yes.
Scratch
it. At number eight, we got Whitman. At number seven, we have Lindenwald.
Scratch that. Y'all ain't even being realistic now.
Yeah. Paulsberg got away. They let people do dumb stuff to them.
It's good teams. It's Woodbury and Deford. They played out of good teams in 10U. So what are you saying?
10U at number six, we got Millville.
That's it. Millville lost everybody.
It was the overtime with y'all last year.
At number five, we got Bridgeton.
I was going offense.
At number four, we got.
Well, I believe Bridgeton should go back. Bridgeton should be at least 10.
Deford at number four.
We got Deford at number four. The top four didn't change from last week. Three, we got Burlington City. And two, Woodbury. And number one, Ricky and the boys over at Sale.
Fuck Sale.
That's 50 on your head.
Oh. Damn. All right, 12.
Y'all blame Q for the 10U rankings.
Yeah, they was hard. That was horrible.
It was horrible, but them teams are horrible. I told you from 7 to 10, pick all poop emojis. From 7 to 10, just pick all poop on them niggas. All of them.
What is up with this you and this poop emoji thing? Yo, bro.
They stand. I don't know where is, though.
You got to hear him on the phone, bro.
I don't know what they do from 6 to 8.
Yeah.
So what do?
Yo, all right, 12.
Yo, no lie though. Monroe played the stall me out game in the second quarter.
Good coaching.
No, I wanted to pick 40 up.
All right, guys, let's get to the 12U. Number 10, we got Camden Predators. Camden Predators jumping on the list.
East side.
Number 9, we got Woodstown.
This 12U?
Yes. Yeah. I think Woodstown could be higher, man. They just got to get up out of that National, man, coming there. And ask. It's time. It's time for Woodstown.
Yep. They had their time. You ducked them.
Oh, my God.
They had their time. Their time. You ducked them.
Yeah. I ducked Woodstown. Yeah.
I was trying hard.
George making videos saying I'm ducking people.
Yo, that's
it. I commented. You know, I commented the duck getting crowned. we got 9 Woodstown. At 8, we got Lindenwald. That's the game we didn't talk about. Recap the Lindenwald.
Yo, Cuzzo, what up?
Number 7.
What did you say about what did you say about Lindenwald violent game? It was something said about that.
Nah, man, it started raining. It was Lindenwald's all right. Well, Lindenwald's gonna be all right.
They got that big running back still.
Nah, they got a tight end. They got a tight end slash wide receiver kid that's elite. It's an elite player. He's one of the best players in Tri County. I like that kid a lot. You know what that
he's
means?
He's one of the best players in Tri County.
Yeah.
Look, he said, you know what that means. Y'all just let that go by, y'all, right?
Nah, I'm trying to bring him back. So he's one of the best in Tri County.
I think he's one of the best kids in Tri County. Yes.
Right. He said, you know what that means.
Well, I don't just throw that out there. I just said he's one of the best kids in Tri County. You know what that means, right?
He's coming.
I got to talk to his parents.
Horrible, man. So I don't recruit. Yeah, right. I don't recruit. I'm going to talk to
this kid's parents.
He said, whoa.
I just need to know why Lindenwald. That's all. Nah, I'm just fucking around. Lindenwald's going to be all right, man. At number 7, we got Woodbury. At 6. Man, this team here dropped down about 4 spots. We got Whitman.
Hey, lucky they ain't out the rankings.
Oh, my God.
They almost got up out of there.
At number 5, we got Monroe.
Now, Al and Kato, I tried to pitch on that, too. But the guy to the left of me would never put you guys at two. I tried to put you guys at two.
Y'all just be snitching.
Yeah, that's what we do.
Bro. At number four, we got Sterling.
Sterling over Whitman?
That's what I'm saying.
Going in a week, too?
Yeah. He thinks Sterling going to win.
Sterling over Whitman.
Three, we got
I don't like Sterling over Whitman or Monroe.
Three, we got Salem.
I don't like Salem over any.
That's the one he was fighting over.
No.
That's the one right there.
Him and, like Salem.
Him and PT wanted Sterling to be over Salem because Salem ain't have a game last week.
I'm like, where the fuck does that make sense? If we rank Salem over Sterling, right, last week, and Sterling plays Kingsway, which we all know not really that good, right? Not good.
Mm-hmm.
They blow him out. Salem don't have a game. You want to say PT's logic was, so Salem ain't play. They move down and Sterling moves over top of him. I'm like, I don't understand that logic though. He's like, that happens all the time. I'm like, but that I don't understand that logic.
Yeah, that happens in actual like. NFL and college ranked.
That's what PT said it happened in college. I just said it doesn't happen in college.
I said, no.
He said, I'll play football all my life.
No. You don't have a game with somebody's 1-0 that always comes above you because you ain't play yet.
No. I'm just saying that, yeah, I mean, 1-0 and the team doesn't have a game, that's different. Right.
You said Kingsbury didn't have a game. They sure enough didn't.
1-0 and 0-0 is different than a team being 1-0 and another team being 2-0.
Right, right.
You see what I'm saying? But I'm not going. This isn't like college football. One, two. What the like? How are we gonna? We try to say who's better than who, right?
Right. Yeah.
So if we already ranked them over them, we can't punish Salem for Winslow not filling the
right,
team.
Right.
You know what I'm saying?
It's just certain things. I'm just biased.
That just don't fucking make sense to me.
I think y'all need to get Q off y'all board rankings.
Anyway.
No, I'm terrible. Monroe's my guy, so I try to help my guys. I picked Cotty at two last week.
Yeah. He advocated for Whitman to be at two, and I said no. But
throw names in the hat.
Monroe at five, Sterling at four. That could easily be flip flopped. You know what I'm saying?
Where you at?
I was just okay. But then we got Brishton at two and then Defford at one.
So Salem's at three?
Yeah.
See, Wayne, you got three wings?
Salem's at three?
Nah,
it's rolling up. Man, y'all beat Woodbury 13-9. We could have scored 100 touchdowns on Woodbury. I don't want to hear nothing. You know, we left points on the board, or we called off the dogs. I don't want to hear it. And Whipper had a touchdown call back and fumbled on the 5-yard line. Y'all was in a goddamn dog fight. I'm gonna call a spade a spade. I don't know what you want from me.
They definitely did fumble down on the. Mm-hmm.
They fumbled on the 4-yard line.
Mm-hmm.
Y'all won 13-0. What do you want from me? You know what I'm saying? Like, versus a team that you should blow out on paper.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? Like. Yeah, well, I don't know what you want from me. I can't put you nowhere other than five. And that's showing love, goddammit. You top five. What else you want? Stone cold hitter. Right. Is that hating? Just observation on the game?
Man, so I really want shit from you.
No. Y'all should have beat Sterling last year. That's what you should have did. You should have fucking beat Sterling last year. We wouldn't be going through this.
Y'all let Sterling come out from the Nationals, start pumping on their chest. Dude, we come up here and beat Monroe. Y'all did this to yourself.
Yeah, all they did was make jackets in the National League for 5 years.
Unbelievable.
Y'all did this shit, man.
Unbelievable.
Y'all the reason why they got Jaden Boyce. They was like, we beat Monroe last year.
That was y'all part of they talking about
the recruit bitch.
With him, we can be different.
Yeah, she came right back around.
Y'all did this shit. Right. I might have been able to get Jaden Boyce if they didn't beat y'all up.
Man, I tried to get Salem out there, Adam. I tried to get Salem out of the top 10.
Salem went to the championship, man. I don't know what else to say.
Yeah, they right.
It all depends what they do with Sincere.
Yeah.
Almost Allen went to the championship.
So it all depends how they use it.
All right. Ooh, yeah. So who's number one?
That's Monroe's fucking that's what they live and die by. But we beat Salem.
Yeah, you know, we beat the shit out of Salem.
But you lost to Sterling. That's worse.
It's Sterling with triple overtime with Woodbury.
But you lost to Sterling, bro. Alright, man, 14U. We got number 10.
He said, how many weeks till last year don't matter? Till about 2 to 3 more weeks.
Man, y'all should have lined it up with us in the scrimmage instead of ducking, and then we could have seen what y'all really. Y'all might have got the two.
Mm. But honestly, it's a 4-man ranking. Like, it's 4-man.
Right, right.
We put it together. We ain't agreeing and being biased. We're just saying our opinions. You know what I mean? Whatever our opinions is. Sometimes it is a little bias on my end, but. I just don't like some of y'all.
Q's very biased, bro.
I am.
He gonna say, but we tied with Philly. I don't even talk about that game. Y'all niggas ain't missed one of our games yet this year. Let's talk about that. Cause y'all niggas was y'all niggas scouting their fans. I turned around, the whole team was on the sideline. I said, "You don't play for Denver, get the fuck off the sideline." Nigga, Juju carrying out the speaker, nigga, I'll be walking out to the fucking 50-yard line. Y'all niggas, bro, y'all got the wrong one.
Sideline Juju. Juju was on every sideline.
I turn around, these niggas, his whole team is on the bench. I said, if you don't play for Denver, get the fuck off the field now.
Yeah.
I don't know if these niggas are scouting their fans, man.
Man, 14U, let's get that last one out the way.
Nah, hold on 1 second, because I like this Deptford Monroe. Isaac hypes me up about Salem. I need to hype this Monroe shit up.
Yeah, hype it up. You know, I like talking about shit.
They got to be ready.
For what?
Damn, I was hoping you didn't bring that up.
Well, I'm hoping Monroe can finally do something. Man, they got the athletes. They got to get the heart.
I give them hope if you want to. You want to crown him? Go ahead and crown him.
Go ahead.
Turn that shit up. Turn that shit up. Nah, because y'all dialed that shit up on me. You know what I mean? I was holding the chains. Monroe talking shit to me. Al making big decisions. Changing the game. Shout out to y'all squad. Y'all make some big decisions. Y'all changed the game. That was coaching.
Man, we going to beat the brakes off now. They know it. That's why they ain't want to. Scrimmage 10 plays. We played on week 8. God damn, nigga, that's in 3 months. Meanwhile, fucking Salem and Bristol just scrimmaged 10 times. These niggas is corny, man. We ain't gonna talk all this shit, but we can right there, ready to line it up. Niggas ain't want to. They got a drone following us around the whole goddamn chamber. Fucking robbing and fucking. We got 100 hours of film on this by now. She done upgraded to a camcorder. She ain't even got the phone no more.
Yeah, leave my girl Miss Robin alone.
Yeah, shout out to Robin. She did my film last night.
Miss Robin do a lot of work out there, man.
Yeah. Y'all better cash up or Venmo her ass, too. She want all that bread.
Man, listen, bro. They recorded everything. You hear me? Everything.
Look, I told y'all coming on here, we ain't talking all about Deffert. What's the next joint?
We ain't talking about that. We talking about Monroe.
All right, what's next? It is getting late.
14U.
What time is it? 11? All right. 14U. We got Willenboro at 10.
Monroe at 1.
We got Eastside. We got Eastside. Eastside started at 9. We got Deffert moves up to 8. Bridgeton at 7, Woodstown at 6, Kingsway at 5. Kingsway moved up. Kingsway had a big win over Sterling. Sterling went from 4 to not even in the rankings no more.
He lost to Kingsway.
Does Woodstown stay up there even with West not there?
Woodstown had a big win. They blew Glassboro out. I don't know what that Glassboro team looked like, but they blew Glassboro out. Woodstown still looks tough without West. West tore his ACL in the jamboree. He hasn't been around for a little while. We got Kingsway at 5. We got Millville at 4. We got Violin at 3. Monroe at 2. and the Woodbury no touchdown Steelers at one. A win is a win.
That definitely was a defensive touchdown.
Yep. Yeah. Pick six. That's what
I said. The crowd was over. I had to do a lot. I was.
Al, you can come on. Al, you
they're
can
like,
come
yo, we'll score 40 points. I'm like,
he offensive coordinator, though, right?
Yeah.
Shout out to my boy Phil. Phil calling the defense. Shout out to him. We held it down. Yeah, we got the victory.
We adapted all the every money. Week, bro.
A win is a win. We got the victory.
Yep. A win is a win.
Monroe got us 3-2, though. They had Pee Wees.
I know y'all better step it up with that monster team out there.
Yeah.
No. Oh, yeah, y'all better do
we got, better, we y'all got, better step it up with that team out there.
You take like I said earlier, we ain't happy about that shit.
You take that down to Florida.
No, that's exactly what we know. That's why we stopped talking about that Florida shit.
Well, all this firepower that's going around on these teams, mm-hmm. it looks like Defer's offense was the only one that really come out and put on the show.
There we go.
Everybody talk about what they got, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
But it seemed like it seemed like Defer's the only one that came out there and put the show. George, I'm telling you right now, I brought you on this show, I can take you out.
Damn.
So I take you out.
I mean, it's just real.
Y'all had fumbles and turnovers too, so you know what I mean? Y'all game wasn't perfect.
We had two fumbles and still put up 45 points.
Hey, it don't matter. You still had, like I said, little if Paulsbury is able to make y'all fumble and all that type of stuff and cause confusion in the backfield, when y'all get to Florida, that ain't going to be pretty either.
What do you mean, bro? Everybody, first of all, nigga. Let's get into it. You can watch any game anywhere. Somebody's going to make a mistake. That don't mean because we fumble versus Paul, bro. That shit ain't going to work in Florida. The fuck are you talking about? It's football.
It's the game of football. Twice.
Sometimes motherfuckers can make a play. Somebody can have a good play call. The one fumble we had, they caught us on the while we were pulling. They shot the A-gap. Our tackle wouldn't go down. He shot through, hit the running back before the quarterback handed the ball off. That's just a good play call that's at the right moment, at the right time in the game. You know what I'm saying? That don't mean you fumble versus Paul, bro. That ain't going to work down Florida. We might fumble down Florida, but we still might bust everybody's ass, just like we bust Paul's bro's ass 45 nothing.
You remember he said he had mind control over me? Look, he really got the mind control. Look at, he had to take a sip. Look at him.
Like, give me two push-ups.
Bang, bang.
That seems like control now, motherfucker. I need two
of them. That's the only thing he got on me.
Right. I need two right now.
It ain't no room.
Shout out to my boy Phil, man. I just seen Phil jump on.
Okay.
Bro, you got me so far, man. We gave up 6 points, man. We got to bet with the seniors who give up the most points, man. Yeah. Hold it down. I put a shutout this week.
He said 27 nothing was on the board. Yeah, they stopped putting points up there. But you know what was on the board in Woodbury? 13.
Y'all niggas scored 6 points for half versus Woodbury. Come on, cuz. One touchdown per half? Are you going to here and tell me they wanted what they want me to do for them?
Q don't want to say nothing because that's his people. Because he want this slime. You said, fuck that.
That's my guys, man. Nah. I was on the sideline. They get coached.
You were trying to be on this political.
Scored 45 touchdowns on them boys. And man, come on, bro. Y'all scored two touchdowns and wouldn't be somewhere.
Shut up. All right, what we got next?
Yeah, right now we got Would You Rather.
What's this sponsored by?
This sponsored by motherfucking Q sweaty ass head.
I'm good today.
Yeah, yeah. Would you rather sponsored by Monroe Ducker Machine?
Damn.
Damn, y'all don't play them till week 8.
Damn.
It's going to be a long couple weeks of us going back and forth. Nah, but they my guys, man. I fucks with you. Know,
facts.
Man. You know, we talk shit because I got to.
Yeah, I played them already, so I can be cool now.
That's what it is.
The game over and done with.
Yeah.
All right, would you rather, man, comment in the comments, man. Would you rather? We like the answers, man. See what y'all say. We got the NFL edition. First week of the NFL also kicked off this week.
Cowboys.
Man, prayers out to my boy Aaron Rodgers, man. Even though I don't like him. He's the reason why I don't got a Super Bowl ring. But he's in our first would you rather. Would you rather on, it says, one final drive. Who would you rather have quarterbacking it, Tom Brady or Aaron Rodgers, for one final drive for you need a touchdown?
I'm going to Tom.
Yeah, I'm going to Tom.
You going Tom Brady?
Yeah, yeah. I'm going to go.
George?
Give me Tom Brady.
Pittsburgh ass too.
Aaron Rodgers is
the best player on death for 12 years.
Yeah. Kato said, "Nah, gloves off." Gloves been off, yeah. Nigga. Fuck y'all niggas, bro.
Everybody picking Tom. Shona said Rodgers.
You didn't play as the A-Rod, man. I was sad to see that yesterday.
That defense was flying.
I didn't even watch the game.
Keep the comments flow, man. I'm gonna wait to the comment. I'm gonna let y'all answer before I go to the next one.
This crowd be fucking me up.
You a little glossy there too,
before I get a little shiny.
You a little glossy. All
right, man. We got a Hail Mary pass. Who would you want? Who would you rather throw it to at the end of the game? Odell Beckham or Julio Jones? Who would you rather throw a Hail Mary pass?
I'm going Julio.
Julio?
Yeah, I'm going Julio.
Q.
Julio.
That's what I was thinking.
He said Moss.
That's what I was thinking.
Moss.
Yeah, George said you should do Moss. I'm like, no, that's too much of a no-brainer.
Yeah, everybody gonna pick
Julio up. Jones and Odell.
Nah, Odell was terrible.
Yeah, I'm gonna take Julio.
Give me Odell.
Odell, he's terrible.
Give me Dez.
I would have said Hopkins
because he called it
in Julio.
I mean, fuck Hopkins. I seen what he said to motherfucking Kevin Ross.
Yeah, that was disrespectful. That was disrespectful.
I was like, see, that's what Kevin Ross get through. He's over there motherfucking ball buffing.
There you go again.
There we go.
Exactly. Go again, what man. The fuck you get over there ball buffing the nigga? He didn't bash me on that.
He said, who are you, dude?
That nigga said, to me, talk. You best receiver in the league. That nigga said, nigga, I know.
Yeah, what is you doing over there ball buffing this nigga, man?
Yo, I was mad as hell, bro. I don't know why that shit made me so mad.
They played that shit too.
Yeah, they played that shit everywhere. He was like, yeah, man, motherfucker, Coach will come over there and talk about I'm the best receiver in the league. I told that nigga I know.
Dang. Like, this nigga Ross, man. Don't let nigga do that to you, man. I said he don't even know Ross would have knocked his motherfucking head off.
Damn. That's all you got?
Nah, we got some. All right, you need a punt return to win the game. DeSean Jackson or Tyreek Hill?
DeSean Jackson.
Give me Reek.
Give me DJ. He already did it.
Yeah, he did it already. Right. That's what I was already thinking.
He already did it.
I just tried to put Tyreek Hill in that position.
Give me Reek, man.
You know that mean? Nigga. Poof.
All right, Deion. Same scenario.
Deion or
Hester.
Deion.
Give me Hester.
D-High stepping at the 50. Deion's starting his high.
Dave Meggett. That nigga in jail. Did you know that? That nigga's in jail.
Yeah, Uncle Willie said he late, but you missed the meeting.
Huh?
Willie said he late, but you missed the meeting tonight.
All right, Willie. Well, I'm that nigga the most policed motherfucker.
Yeah,
I'm like, worrying about me missing the meeting.
Yeah, I'm going Deion.
Yeah, give me Deion.
Deion.
Give me Hester.
Speed 100 on Madden.
Oh, shit. Rapist Megan. Oh, shit. I'm done with that. Why did I say that name?
Do y'all remember Eric Metcalf?
Yes.
Yeah, Metcalf was a dude.
Yo, Eric Metcalf was one of my favorite players. Now,
yeah, I remember him.
Hester is definitely the best to ever do it. How can y'all pick Deion over Hester, bro?
Because Deion's the best to ever do it.
Because he's prime.
Best to ever do it.
He wasn't a better return than Hester, bro.
Is Hester or Hall from KC?
Remember him?
Hall was the
weapon X, the original weapon X.
Deion Joystick.
Yo, that nigga used to, He made two Pittsburgh guys.
Mm-hmm. You ain't gonna be talking about Pittsburgh.
I'm just saying. I'm trying to remember that.
Yeah, Willie said your shit on the last snap, George.
Snapback, Willie.
I almost spit this beer.
Ain't need a snapback, Willie. Now, Willie, when I get you, I'm gonna get you good. You already know me. When I get, I'm gonna get you good.
Would you rather have Jimmy Garoppolo or Kirk Cousins?
Oh my God!
Jimmy G.
Yeah, it's a Jimmy G. Kirk Cousins stinks.
Yo, Jimmy G give you 85 yards. Kirk Cousins gonna give you 300, but still lose.
He's gonna lose the game.
But Jimmy G giving you 85 yards.
He gonna get 85 with no picks.
Yeah, I took that.
Damn, that's hard.
You know? I lose picks on fucking Vikings every year.
Yo, I'm forfeit. Can I forfeit?
Weem said neither.
Right? Yeah.
Weem said neither.
Nah, you gotta pick one or take a shot.
Now I'm drunk.
I know B Max on here. Shot o'clock.
Yeah.
Shot o'clock, fellas.
Good. Oh, shot o'clock.
Yeah, I know B Max on here somewhere. He got something expensive in the cup.
Good Lord.
Yeah, I go Jimmy G. Fuck it.
I gotta work tomorrow.
Me too.
Me too.
Shut up. He gonna watch film tomorrow. That's what the fuck he gonna do.
I ain't got no game this week.
Oh, that's right.
We relaxing.
He playing Fortnite and Call of Duty.
All right, we got would you rather have a great head coach with a below average staff or below average head coach with a great staff?
Oh, man.
Give me the below average head coach with a great
staff. I think the staff would get you more prepared. Isn't that who you're with most of the time anyway?
That's tough.
Because they're your position coaches. They're the ones really teaching you what you need to know and getting you prepared. The coach is just the motivator.
Yeah, I take great staff.
Yeah, I'll take great staff.
There's a lot of head coaches out here that either run an offense.
Yeah. No, I'm just trying to think, like, when you got a great staff, when you go to your meetings and all that shit, you with your staff.
I think it's easier for a team to come better with a better staff. Mm-hmm. And a less fortunate head coach than a, you know what I mean, a better coach than a staff.
Sometimes you'll have a dumbass head coach.
Yeah. Oh my God. Because he can supersede everything. And the great staff is just nothing they can
sometimes
do.
Sometimes a great coach can turn a below average staff into a great staff.
Yeah, but that's not what you're giving us.
Yeah, no, I'm just saying. But you know, it's a possibility. Right. What can happen with that?
It looked like everybody chose the great staff.
Yeah.
Gotta have a great staff around you, man.
Yeah,
I'm not as good as your staff.
Yep.
What if you had to pick one pair of Jordans, what would they be?
I don't know. I ain't no fucking Jordan.
I never had a pair of Jordans in my life. Well, I just had a pair. My son just bought me a pair for Christmas.
Listen, dog, I was broke.
What numbers were they?
I do not know.
I have no idea. Those right there.
Yeah.
I don't fucking know.
I got them ones.
Yeah, I do got them.
Mine's ain't
y'all know. Y'all know old Puerto Rican. He had the 6 rings.
Jeez. I had nothing nowhere near Jordan's.
The Spanish fly.
That's that Palmyra shit, dog.
And nigga got the 6.
Yeah, I better tell you, I had a nickname for y'all team too. Yeah. Y'all my Spanish Harlem niggas, man.
I'm like, yo, every coach on this team is Spanish, man. Y'all my Spanish Harlem niggas, man.
Yeah, I don't know them Jordans like that.
Yeah, me either.
In the comments, I'm gonna fill up on the Jordans.
Yeah, I don't know nothing about Jordans.
Yeah, I don't know nothing about Jordans, really, man.
That's funny, the 6 rings.
Shout to Poppy Ayers. I know I got those upstairs. I don't even know what numbers they are.
That Poppy Ayers.
Yo, whatever those are, I got them upstairs.
It's them Jordans with 3 different Jordans all in one shoe.
Damn. It's like a 3
jump man. The jump man.
Yo, that's funny.
They got the ones, threes, and sixes all in one shoe.
Shit.
Combined.
I got the fours on right now.
Never had a pair of them.
Yeah, me neither. Give me a pair.
They said, see, you're rich. You got every pair of Jordans. I said, nigga, ain't nobody. Shut the fuck up.
Damn.
He said, well, I want these right here. I'm so fucking said $450. Let me get the fuck out of my face.
You don't need to wear a smoke. You wear Crocs every day. Would you rather play the best team in your division in the beginning of the season or the end of the season?
In our division.
In your league. If you had to play the best team in the league, would you rather be in the beginning of the year or toward the end of the year?
Ooh, that's I got good. 7, week 7.
I'm going to say the beginning.
I like it.
That can tear your kids' confidence up more than that.
Well, we know Monroe would rather play playing them at the end.
We're in the scrimmage. We play you guys every game.
They told us, they said, we won't meet y'all again. I was like, damn. I'm mad as hell. We won 7-0. They already like, we going to meet y'all again.
They already know what it is.
Yeah, I was like,
I mean, they got a reason to feel like that, though.
I'll send you the video. You'll see.
Damn.
Me and PT had this talk earlier. And he was like, I was like, you know what? We're going to end this. I'm going to send you the video.
Mm-hmm.
He saw the video, man. I'm not going to sit there and lie.
PT did a comment on here and say that y'all left a lot of points on the
board. Yeah, hell yeah, bro. It's proof, though. You know what I mean? I ain't talking out my ass. Whoa, I knew it. He leaned on that one.
Do y'all have a pause segment for this man today?
Yeah, we about to get to
it. He need a pause segment.
You ain't got none, but I got one.
I know you got a story.
Yeah, right, man. Go with you.
We got, if you had to pick. you rather coaching slides every game.
I'm not coaching those slides.
Or pink Crocs.
Neither.
Nah, you gotta pick one.
You gotta pick one.
Give me the Crocs.
Yeah, I mean, it's not the slides. I mean, slides. I meant the slides.
Now you gotta say pause.
I meant the slides.
Pause.
I meant the slides. I'll
hit
the slide. I never even had a pair of Crocs.
Yeah.
Give me the slide.
Yeah, you have to coach some slides every game or some pink Crocs.
I'll take that, Al.
I'm gonna just hope it's in the month of October. Give me the pink Crocs.
George is so against the motherfuckers coaching the slides. I ain't gonna lie, give me the pink Crocs, dude, because I'm gonna freak them joy. I'm a breast cancer to show out the motherfucker.
Yeah, give me the pink Crocs.
I haven't had a pair of Crocs.
Me neither. I don't even know what they feel like.
Flip flops on a coach on a football field is
that's nasty work.
When somebody gets you with that nasty work, that's funny.
I got that from Ooze. I don't know where it came from. Ooze came to me one day and said, "Yeah, that's nasty work." I'm like, what?
That's the dude that be he be going on motherfuckers where they be having the fake J's and shit on. Y'all ain't never seen?
Nah.
He be like, that's nasty work.
I posted that corduroy hat. They said, that's nasty work.
I'm saying something from the borough and motherfuckers. That's nasty work.
Nah. What's more embarrassing? Getting fired from a volunteer job or your real job?
Damn.
Would you rather be Sewell or would you rather get fired from your real job?
I never got fired from neither.
What's more embarrassing, getting fired as a volunteer or getting fired from your real job?
A volunteer. That's the worst.
What's more?
That's nasty work.
He said nasty work is crazy.
Yo, shit. It's funny how as soon as he said volunteer, everybody started. Everybody knew it.
Sewell Idris from
Millville.
Him and Sherwood.
How you get fired from a volunteer job? You can get fired from a volunteer job.
This roach ass right
there.
Let me talk about that. You can, just because you're a volunteer doesn't mean you're above being fired or being let go. You know what I'm saying? Just because you're a volunteer in your time, you're not being paid for, you're still volunteering to do a job.
Right.
Right? So if you're not doing your job or doing what you're supposed to be doing.
You're held. Still held.
Yeah, you still
got to be accountable.
Right, you're still supposed to be doing a job. You're supposed to be teaching the game football. If you're not doing it to what the board members of your organization or president of your organization believes is the standard, your ass can be fired.
That's not always true.
I mean, what do you mean by that?
That's not always the situation. People getting fired from volunteers.
What are you trying to say?
There's just other situations that can happen.
There is a lot of other situations that can happen. You could be out there doing some bull. You can be out there be on the whole. But it could. You could be winning the championship every year, but be out there stealing money.
Lend
you know what I'm saying?
Lend the ball. These won championships.
You take the cup away.
This is
only when I come on the show, y'all.
Yeah. No, get Q away from me, bro. Not get his seat away from me, bro.
Yeah. Things got fired at the championship.
Bro. Man, they told me, man, they was like, man, we was cheating. Like, damn.
Yo, all right, man. Last one, man.
Would you rather the rankings be done every week or every 2 to 3 weeks?
I think every 2 to 3 is kind of easy because everything just sets up. Everything sets itself up for you. I like the every week because what we went through on the phone.
Yeah.
We were just going back and forth. And then...
I mean, since I've been doing my rankings.
It's hard. I like the challenge.
We do it every, you know what I mean? This week we couldn't do it just because I had, you know what I mean, a lot of BS going on. But every week the rankings change.
Right.
Somebody wins, somebody
loses. Right.
Somebody in those rankings play each other, you know what I mean? So they can switch at any time during that time.
Yeah, every 2 to 3 weeks doesn't make sense to me. Like,
I like every 2 to 3 weeks because everybody stinks.
Take his cup from me.
Like if you do like every 2 to 3 weeks, right? You giving somebody, you might be slighting somebody. They couple weeks at the number one spot. You know what I'm saying? So if Defford loses, we lose to Lindenwall, right?
Ooh,
we lose to Lindenwall, and we don't do rankings for 3 weeks.
Defford
number one for three
weeks. In that 3 week period, you could drop down to like number four and then win two more weeks and move back up to one.
Yeah.
So from that week to week, you're still number one.
Yeah. You're right.
So, you know what I mean? So I like, you know, that allows teams to, you know,
move that's around. What I say, Adam. So much inconsistency.
Yeah. I'm like, but week to week, it's not like everybody's not playing each other, though. So week to week, you literally have everybody's playing each other week to week. You know what I mean? So it's like every week we get to reorder the rankings and see how our rankings from the preseason match up with how everything ends off. So
right. No, I like it. Shit, I like the every week. I like that challenge we got presented with today.
So the other day at the Paulsboro field, right?
Hold on, is the ranking segment over?
Well, that was the Would You Rather.
What was that segment by?
We had it. Center.
Yeah, y'all want to see how I answered that.
Dead ass, dude.
Yo.
Dead ass.
Yo,
what happened? Yo, hold on.
What segment was that? His head.
Yeah. Q, I love you, dog.
That was funny.
All of.
That was funny.
Yo, what happened with Matawan?
I don't know. I'm on my business with them.
No, I'm saying, did they lose or something?
Yeah, they lost. Yeah. Oh, they lost.
Who did they lose?
I don't know, but they lost.
They lost to... Who the hell did they play?
Yeah, who
did they play? Matawan?
Big Fish, yeah. Big Fish, who Matawan lose to? Big Fish said, yeah, Matawan got problems with
that. Oh, Maryland. Yeah, Maryland Heat.
Maryland Heat.
Maryland Heat.
14-year,
yep.
Right?
Yep.
Maryland Heat, 14-year wasn't all that I heard.
Nah, because they all left, right?
They all
left.
Some of them went back down to
13-year. 13-year, yeah. That's what I heard.
Shout out to the AYF team getting big victories this weekend.
What was the score? What was the score, Big Fish? Yo, fucking, yeah, my boy said some funny shit to me. He said, man. Or my boy got on the live.
Yeah. With that one. What's his name again?
Oh, my homeboy?
Yeah.
Oh, that's my boy Cuddy. Yeah, I call him Cuddy. But his name Travis.
Mm-hmm.
He was like, he went to go tell the coach, like, yo, look.
Damn.
Oh, my. Damn. My.
Good Lord.
My.
Good Lord. I wasn't expecting that.
Ouch.
31-6.
They'll be raping you.
We'll be raping you.
Damn.
Get your all new ass back.
9.99.
Damn, y'all took it back. I'm a rough rider.
What was your shout-outs, George? George, you better give some shout-outs. What was your shout-out?
Who was that? Olympus. 7U, 9U, and 11U getting big wins over South Philly Sharks. We had Brandon getting a huge win over the 302 Steelers.
You know, Brandon got a win?
Damn.
he called fire or house or something.
Brandon 2-1 right now. You know what I mean? Brandon got a big win over the 302 Steelers out of Delaware. You know what I mean? A dominant 9U team out of Delaware.
Give it up for Brandon.
And the rest of the Winslow Eagles took care of the Bronx Wolfpack. Lindenwald at EFP had a game of the week. Lindenwald won that. No, EFP won that game.
Yeah, was it 11U?
Yeah, 7-6.
Oh, not dang, that's a good game.
7-6. It was either a good game or a lot of penalties.
Where was that at?
That was at Lindenwald High School under the lights, 7 o'clock.
Oh, nice.
Under the lights game. So
is anybody going to talk about Lindenwald 0-3? Or 11U? Or are you going to talk about that? Or?
They 0-3.
Hey, I was wondering if anybody was going to talk about.
Yeah, right now Lindenwald is 0-3.
Get your whole new ass back. $9.99.
They currently are 0-3, but like I did say earlier, AYF, you know what I mean. Your regular season really don't mean much. That's just your qualifying games to get to the AYF tournament. They can still win, you know what I mean, a championship for the Yellow Pages. They got Olympus ahead of them. And they got an EFP ahead of them.
Man, we're going to come over to the Yellow Page next year and fuck shit up.
Go ahead. Go represent South Jersey. That's what it is.
Man, my top recruit for next year then got hurt.
Oh, yeah, EFP 10U, Q. They be ASG 20-9.
Go West. He be all right. He be back.
That's okay.
Another Quello.
All right, man. Well.
Well, where's your story at?
Oh, for Brown Paul, bro? Yeah. For the Paul segment?
Yeah.
Q don't got nothing for the Paul segment, but I got something.
It's horrible.
All I know is we was on.
I already heard the story.
He does. I got it. We was in Paul, right bro, man. Niggas was passing a black mile around. And, nigga handed Mikey, I'm the boss, gives the mob.
Damn.
And nigga Stevie said, oh, Mike, let me get that. And Mike said, no, I already let four niggas hit it.
I said, no, Stevie, he's sore. Gotta wait 10 minutes.
Y'all should see Q right now, y'all.
He said Q fire right.
Y'all should see Q right now.
Hey yo. I fucking lost it, bro.
He said he's sore. He's in 10 minutes.
Said, no, Steve.
I already let four niggas hit it.
I'm saying that nigga's sore.
You want to tell the would you rather story?
Oh, man.
Oh, God.
About the girlfriend dying.
No, shit. That's what I'm falling down.
So this is a major pause. Like, oh my major. God. I'm going to take my headphones
off. Yeah. Man, yo. Shauna was right there. I said, hold on, let me write this down on my notes so I don't forget what you said.
Yo. Yo. I already left four niggas in. Yo.
So there was this joint, you know how the dudes be going to like clubs and interviewing motherfuckers and shit, right? So I seen this online, and it was a would you rather, and it said, not would you rather, but it was watch your girl die or jerk your man's off.
Bitch, you dead.
That's what the dude said. That man said. She dead.
Oh my god. Can't do it.
Sorry, baby.
Leave everything to me.
He was on his live again. Yeah,
she got a black eye.
Oh, man.
Oh, yo, what this nigga Mikey said, I already let four niggas in it.
He gonna go back to that again.
Oh, man.
Cause when I tell you, bro, I was, bro, I had to write it down, man.
Yo, that was a good one.
That was the worst one of I've heard in a long time, bro.
No, O's is the worst.
No, come on, man.
What?
I'm gonna leave it back up for you.
Scott, they flipped that shit so fast, bro.
Yeah, I will. Let me read IRS text message real quick.
Yo, whoa. What he said? Back door open.
Yo, what did I say? Bro, I've been no bullshit, bro. No, I didn't. I ain't said no boy.
It say the address, and it say come to the back door.
It's that basement. Nah, back door.
This nigga lying, bro.
He said back door is open.
Hey, Kato, we gonna do a quick prediction show sometime this week. Cause I already knew this was gonna take all the time.
Shit, we at 11:30. Shit, I gotta get ready for work.
Fuck,
man, I need water.
Yo, y'all crazy, man.
Yo, man.
Nigga said I said the back come through the back door. I ain't say that shit, bro.
Talking crazy, son.
Yo, Mikey must be asleep, man. Mikey ain't get on a podcast.
Hey, yo, Jay Turkin, niggas, I'm making all that damn noise. Hey, yo, shit.
What's up, and no hood strips, I got more words than pips. And I'm in the diner, I don't leave tips unless they hollow. What? Y'all amateurs like them little niggas at the pop.
He took us back to 0203. 0203 right now.
What's popping? You
Jay jerking niggas. That's
kind of sucks. Yo, what is Civic no more? I'm trying to get that, man. What you want to push for the summer? You need a Jeep set no more. I'm going to get you the stage. I'll get you the key of the mall. Dubs ain't going to fit on it, but I'm going to get you some tins. You got to keep them clean, though.
Thank you, Jeep.
You keep it clean. Never chrome. Only alloys. No way you're gonna get chrome. No way. What else you need, Daddy? What's bothering you, baby?
Tyson in the back on the plane.
What else you need, Daddy?
Look at the first class, no doubt. Sunjet, baby. All the seats are leather.
Yo, man, listen, man. We appreciate all y'all, man, tuning in. Great show, man. We're back.
Oh, yeah, play the song for him.
Shout out to the Yellow Pages. AYF South Jersey.
That's just the beat.
Yo,
bro,
intro.
I got it. Yeah,
now
it's
the outro.
So
shout out to the fellas for having us on here tonight.
Yeah, man. Shout out to the Yellow Pages, man. Slide
Q,
we all in the building.
Q, Red.
Yo, next week I'm going freestyle. Y'all don't know I got bars.
I'm gonna go find a freestyle from Red when he was 13.
Bro, we used to go bars, bro.
Yeah. Shout out to Monroe.
Fuck yeah, I'm gonna do a diss track on Monroe to that beat. How about that? We gotta start doing diss tracks.
Catch you in that red zone and then on my cue. Coach O draw up the play and we gon' slide through. Slime you, get you stepped over like Ty Lue. It don't matter if you 6'9 or you 5'2. Throwing them pads, put on the cleats, foot in the dirt, slip on the gloves, yelling out straps, ain't nothing sweet. You can get hurt out on the field, ride for the team, grass in the streets, even on turf, snapping on three, throwing them dots, see the technique, putting in work. Hail Mary, feeling something like I'm Pac. If it ain't us, then you nothing but a eye. Tri-County, man, we coming for your slot. High bounty, put a hundred on your top. We seen crime, seen drugs, seen murder, seen guns, seen death, seen jail, seen further. This game done saved some lives. We certain, we grind, we hustle, we moving, we working.